In the annals of Canberra, Malcolm Turnbull's A-team is hard at work. An election is nigh, and they need a slogan that, like their leader, is confused and stands for nothing.
Drum roll, please. Can anybody guess?
New chairs?
No, a new copier.
For all the copying our PM does, behold!
Continuity and change.
That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard.
And it's the second time you've heard it.
In season 4 of Veep, we came up with the most meaningless election slogan we could think of, now adopted by the Australian PM.
You've got to be shitting me.
Nope. Mal stole his slogan from the pretending politics show Veep. Here's the pretending.
Continuity with change.
Here's the real life.
There is continuity and there is change.
Pretending.
Continuity with change.
Real life.
There is continuity and there is change.
You'll understand that I now have to go and speak to my colleagues.
Yes, and we've obtained exclusive vision of that talk.
The level of incompetence in this office is staggering.
Yeah, it's not the first time the Libs have had slogan issues.
In 1990, the Liberal Party had for their slogan, they had "The answer is Liberal," to which Bob Hawke quickly replied, "If the answer is Liberal, the question is stupid."
But we can't be too hard on Malcolm. Anthony Albanese once plagiarised a speech from a fake American president. Look, here's the pretending.
We have serious problems to solve, and we need serious people to solve them.
Here's real life.
We have serious challenges to solve, and we need serious people to solve them.
No, please. There's more.
He is interested in two things. Making you afraid of it and telling you who's to blame for it.
Slogan stealing's a universal ailment. So rife, there's an old adage for it that I just made up. If you're gonna steal a slogan, don't steal it from a pedo. Bush's "Jeb can fix it" was eerily similar to the retrospectively pervy "Jim'll fix it." A slogan used by the decades-long sex offender Jimmy Savile.
Please clap.
Needless to say, the only thing that slogan fixed was Jeb's reputation as a sad, disconnected old man with no hope of ever becoming president. Still, it's not the worst presidential slogan in US history. That one goes to a man named Al Smith, who in 1928 came up with this doozy.
Vote for Al Smith and make your wet dreams come true.
Yeah. In case you were confused, he ran on an anti-prohibition, not pro-masturbation platform.
Oh, kinky.
All jokes aside, we wanted to find out what actually makes a good political slogan.
No slogan on its own, can do anything, really. What it does do, what you try to do with a slogan is capture the mood for at that time. Anything that makes the leader's name, makes you remember that, so J for SA or even Kevin 07, those ones tend to be good.
If only Mal had heeded such advice, or even his own.
We need advocacy, not slogans. We need to respect the intelligence of the Australian people.